Welcome back to the Halftime Report. We're answering your questions now. First up, Brandon from Ohio asks, should I keep American Airlines long term? Pete.
I do like the name a lot. My favorite name in the space still remains Delta. I own that in terms of stock, but I think American works as well. I know Surat loves that that space as well.
You want to give an answer on that too before we get to you on a question?
I would keep American for a trade, but I would keep Delta for a long term.
Oh, okay, good stuff. We have a question for you next. Wayne asks, I bought L Brands at $30 near the bottom. What do I do? Should I hold it? Where do you think the stock goes from here?
So be prepared for a rocky ride. We own it. I like it at these levels. I still think it's cheap, but it's a turnaround story. So this is not a quarter turnaround. This could be a couple quarters.
Okay. Our friend Dino tweets us, are Applied Materials and Cisco buys before upcoming earnings? So, Jim, you own Cisco. What do you think about this?
So I'll start with Cisco. The answer is yes. Look, they had a very disappointing guidance after the last earnings, and that sets them up well because usually what they do is they sandbag, and then the next quarter they come up and they exceed. So I would expect Cisco to do well this quarter. On AMAT, that's a much longer-term play. Now, the stock's been doing very well, and it's very cheap. I like it as a long-term play because all the new chip designs are going to require AMAT equipment to produce it. So long term, that's a great investment.
All right, here's one from Alex. Thank you, Alex. Which is a better buy? Joe, this is for you. XLF, KBE, or the KRE?
Well, Alex, first of all, let's remove KBE. That one I don't want to buy. XLF is very interesting. Obviously, you're getting the big banks in there, plus a little bit of Warren Buffett exposure. But I still believe KRE, that's the right way to play the financial trades for the remainder of the second half of the year.